This is a prototype of a foldable 3D printer I've been working on. It uses a scissor lift mechanism for the Z-axis. Right now, all the custom parts are 3D printed just to verify the design. So no, it can't actually print yet. And since it's not the final version, I haven't cut the wires either, just in case I cut them too short. I first saw this kind of foldable design on Hacker Day, where
Malte Schrader
created the X printer and X printer V2. I really liked the concept and thought there was some potential to improve it. Now, let me show you what I've changed compared to the original X printers. The first major change is the removable printhead. In both of Malte's designs, there's a rectangular cutout on the heat bed to make room for the printhead when folded. I didn't like that compromise. My initial idea was to make the heat bed removable, like the positron 3D printer, but that would complicate the design. Additionally, having a non-removable printhead limits how tall it can be without sticking out of the frame. So instead of removing the bed, I made the printhead removable. Right now, it's held in place with two screws, and you need a flathead screwdriver to install it. This is just because of how compact the printer is. I haven't found out a better way to lock it securely while keeping the size down. The next change is the access drive. Malte mentioned in his project log that the ball screw and Z motor are experiencing really high resistance when the printer is in a relatively tight folded position. One side of the scissor lift could even be pushed down easily. And in the V2 version, he used two 10mm belts on each side, connected by a shaft and driven by a geared NEMA 17 motor. Honestly, I think both versions are overcomplicated. So instead of using the timing belts to handle the load, I decided to use a single NEMA 11 stepper motor to drive two T5 lead screws through a timing belt. That way, the load stays on the lead screws and avoid the needing of an expensive stepper gearbox. What's more, I added some conical springs under the XY gantry. The springs will act as counterweights to balance the extreme force when the printer is at relatively low position. Next, I redesigned how the scissor arms are mounted. The front and middle joints now use precision shoulder screws with angular contact bearings and thrust bearings. This lets me preload the joints for better rigidity. For the rear joints, I used 25 and 30mm inner threaded guide pins mounted directly on the scissor arms that rotate inside two spaced apart ball bearings housed in a 3D printed bracket. Using two bearings spaced out like this increases rigidity way more than just using a single bearing. The last change is the XY belt structure. I was originally using PBot, what we usually refer to when saying core XY, but even with 3mm belt, I wasn't able to compress the printer height to 65mm to fit into a filament box. So I decided to switch to HBot structure. The good side of HBot is it only needs one belt, which significantly simplifies the structure and has a lower height. But the downside is ranking forces. When both motors move in the same direction, the gantry twists because of the unequal belt tension. To reduce the effect, I'm using the longer version of MGN7 sliders. Without pushing the acceleration too high and not using direct drive extruder to reduce printhead weight, HBot should work fine for a printer this small. I'll test the structure with real linear rails before the actual build to see if HBot can handle the acceleration I need. Now, there are a few things I'm not satisfied with this prototype. First, the removable printhead needs to be tool-free. I'm planning to use a cam lever to lock a tapered dovetail structure for maximum rigidity at minimum thickness. For the electrical connection, I'm planning to use magnet pogo pins. This would make the printhead become truly quick swap. Also, the prototype uses a 3010 part cooling fan to save space, which I don't think is enough for high-speed PLA printing. So I'm probably going to switch to a bigger fan or use remote cooling. The overall size of the printer also needs to be reconsidered. Trying to squeeze everything into a filament box sounds cool at first, but when you already have the positron, which nails area efficiency to over 80%, it starts to feel a bit pointless. Right now, the printer uses a 150x150mm heat bed with a print volume of 140x140x130. So, instead of forcing it into that same constraint, I'm going to expand the design to fully use that 150x150 heat bed. The HBot setup is still under evaluation. The 3D printed reels are too flexible, so I need to do some tests with real linear reels. If the gantry cannot handle the ranking forces, I'll probably switch back to PBot setup. I'd love to hear your feedback. What kind of features do you want in a foldable printer like this? What is the minimum build volume that still feels usable to you? And if you got any thoughts or suggestions, definitely drop them in the comments.